Speaking of middleweights, Lou, speaking of
they're all possible, but right now, who knows, with Canelo playing around with Golovkin, I mean, that's going to, like, you know, it remains to be seen.
Could Jacobs happen?
Who, a lot of things could happen.
Right. Do you think they, like,
I don't know, man. Do you, like, realistically, you figure this motherfucking business out, are you kidding me? Can you ever figure out does what goes on in boxing often, is it what makes the most sense?
No.
Not always, man. You know, so, like, don't ask me to fucking predict, because I can't.
Lou, pivoting to right here and right now.
Yeah.
Were you able to make sense of Mr. Broner yesterday and really what going at Leonard Ellerbe? It was pretty harsh. Your thoughts on it? Was that off the rails? Was that AB being AB?
I mean, that was a lot of that was AB being AB. I mean, that's a lot of it, man. And you know what? There's a lot of people, like, a lot of people sniping at a lot of people in this business all the time, including people who sniping at people what they work with. I mean, it's all the time. It's not anything surprising. And the other thing about AB being AB is, you know, as much as I shake my head a lot of time or bite my lip sitting on a dais or whatever, I mean, the motherfucker is an entertainer. And people eat it up. And you know, if he wasn't, he knows what he gets a response on. He knows where to push buttons to get a response. He loves making people react to him, whether it's with love or it's not. I mean, he understands how to market and sell himself. Now he's got to win.
Right.
See, now he's got to win because he's got the star power and he's got the ability to attract the crowds and attract the people and get people to care about him. This room's going to have all these people in it because there are a lot of people that care about him. And there are also a lot of people that care about Javante and Charlo also, but really, Broner is, look at his social media following, look at the stuff he gets himself into and the way he knows how to get a lot of attention, whether it's for positive reasons or not. You have to give the guy props at understanding how to command attention, okay? But at some point, you got to win the big fight.
Do you think it's fair?
And now he's got to win the big fight. He's got to get in there Saturday night and he's got to win, because if he doesn't win, all this other stuff's not going to keep him at the top without him winning.
Do you think it's fair when they say he's become in this era Zab Judah, like, talent to be in the pound for pound, but when he gets to fights the top guys, he comes up short?
I mean, there's no questioning he has immense talent. There's no questioning that. There's also no questioning that in a lot of the biggest fights he hasn't come through. Okay? But I want to see, I am curious. Like, I'm not buying into any propaganda or whatever. I just know Kevin Cunningham, and I know who he is. I know that AB, if AB had a camp with Cunningham and he made it through that camp, had he messed around in that camp, he wouldn't be in that camp. So I know you're going to see whatever the clowning yesterday and the dancing and the music and the headphones or whatever. If you have any doubts you're going to see the guy in shape, I don't doubt it. I think he's going to be in shape.
I think
you're going to see the best of him. I just think you're going to see the best of Vargas too. And you're going to see a younger dude who throws a lot of punches, who's got nothing to lose. It's all upside for Jesse Vargas, you know? You know, so I'm really looking forward to the main event. I think it's going to be a good fight.
What's